I'm out here in Marfa, Texas today at this very unique two-story shipping container home. It's made up of two 40-foot containers, and the owners did a lot of framing to create this very unique container build that I've never seen before. We're also here in Marfa, which is an art center and has a lot to offer out here in the desert in Texas, but more on that later. For now, let's hop into a tour of this incredible container home. Welcome to this very unique two-story shipping container home out here in Marfa, Texas. This is the main front exterior of the home. The owners again told me they took two 40-foot containers, they cut up one of the containers, and the rest of the home is made up of some more traditional framing. A very interesting layout. Now in the backyard, you can see the staircase which leads to the second floor, and you get a better picture of how these containers are laid out. You can see one of the 40 footers there on the right hand side, and in this area you also have a nice outdoor seating area. Now back in front, you can see more of those huge windows as I sip a cup of coffee. And if we zoom out with the drone, you'll notice the container home sits on a nice chunk of land. Now, just a short drive away from the container home, you can head into the town of Marfa. As mentioned earlier, Marfa is a really cool cultural and arts hub out here in the desert in Texas, and there are some beautiful buildings around, like the Marfa City Hall you see here. But that's everything for the surrounding area. Let's now head back to the home to begin to head inside. To enter, we'll walk past this metal gate. You can see the other 40-foot container chopped in half. Part of it is there up top. The other section is where the door is. So now I'm gonna walk up this little deck to that door, open it up, and let's go and check out the interior. This is your first glimpse into the interior. You can see some of the living room and dining area. But if you now glance back towards the door we just entered into from, you see through that little door on the right, you do have a half bathroom here on the main floor. The coolest feature by far is you have a little mirror that is made out of a giant horseshoe. We'll now walk further into this main area. You can see some cool decorations sitting on top of that window and in the far corner. If we then come to the dining table, you can swing out these chairs, which I think is a great way to save some space, in my opinion. We'll now hook left and venture into the main living room area. This main floor has quite an open floor plan. This particular section is made up more of framing, not any containers. But as we pan to the left, you can see some more comfy seating options like that leather couch, this other chair in one corner, and on the opposite end, an even larger chair with a pillow of a dog, and this very bright and eye-catching mirror on the wall. This is your view if you're sitting on the couch. You can look out through those huge windows. But if we actually now open up the coffee table like this, there's a bunch of helpful reading materials inside, a bunch of info on some of the art exhibits in Marfa, and especially this very helpful map. So I definitely suggest opening up this coffee table and giving all this stuff a read through as soon as you check in. Next up, we'll now head in this direction into the kitchen. Me personally, I love kitchens where there's not a ton of drawers and everything is just kind of out in the open. It really opens up the space, in my opinion. Over on the left, you do have a large stainless steel fridge and freezer though, and here a bunch of shelves with all of your plates, condiments, and kitchen supplies. Over here, you do have a double sink, which makes it super easy to wash up dishes. And if we move further down, you have an oven and your stovetop area with four burners. You also have tons of pots and pans if you want to do some cooking. I think overall, this kitchen felt very artsy, almost urban to me, something you may find in a Brooklyn loft. We'll now head in this direction to check out the other side of the container home. You can actually see one of the containers there on the left, but this is a connecting hallway meant mostly for storage, and you have a washer and dryer unit if you like to do any laundry. We'll now walk all the way to the end and come into the master bedroom. They carved out a bunch of windows into a container for this room. The most noticeable one is right above the bed. There's also a bunch of cool accessories in this room, like these two little boots that make up a lamp. You also have a bunch of pillows. If we now look into that far corner, you have a little bit of storage space. You have two rows of hangers and another cool lamp sitting on top of this table. To finish off in the bedroom, I had to test out the king size mattress, which was very comfy. If you look the opposite way, you have a little sitting area and some cool decorations like this one hanging from the wall. You also have this almost reflecting orb and some arrows along this one. We'll now move into the ensuite bathroom. You have this nice sink area and a giant mirror. If we move further in, you then have your shower towels, your toilet, and finally, you have your shower over here, which I think perfectly matches the aesthetic of the rest of the container home. Now, I do want to mention on Airbnb that you can individually rent out the first or second floors. You can also message the host to rent both floors at the same time if you have a larger group. But now back outside, I'm going to climb up these stairs and enter through this door to the second floor. We are now in the second floor guest suite. You have a little kitchen table as soon as you walk in and this bright green couch. Along that far wall, you have your kitchenette and some basic kitchen supplies, including this mini fridge and freezer and a toaster oven. If we now walk further in, this entire second floor guest suite is roughly the size of a 20-foot container, I believe. But here is your bed wedged into this corner, and beneath the bed, you have a few storage bins for some extra space. If we face the opposite way, you have a little sitting area and a TV along this wall. But now we're gonna walk into your own private bathroom here on the second floor. It's a little more modern than the bathroom downstairs, especially the shower with the bright white subway tile. You also have a little sink area and a circular mirror over here. Still in the bathroom, if we pop through this door, it will take us to outdoor deck number 1 of 2 on the second floor. Let's now head over to the main outdoor deck. Directly accessed from the second floor guest suite, this is the main outdoor deck. It is private just to the second floor guests unless you decide to rent out both floors, but you do have a comfy hammock and this nice outdoor couch with another table. In the far corner, you then have some more seating options, including this little outdoor dining table. From this bird's eye view, you can see more of the difference between the containers and the framing on the left. But this is a great outdoor space. I ended my final night here chilling in the hammock, and I grabbed this drone shot right around sunset. Thanks for watching, guys. There's a link to my container home playlist in the video description, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.